Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's DevTalk. We're just going to hold the line here for about another minute or so and let folks log in, and then we'll be ready to kick off our webinar today. Thanks so much. Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's DevTalk. We appreciate your attendance today, and we're looking forward to hearing about customizing Zebra Enterprise Keyboard for your applications. As a matter of check-in and housekeeping and some updates for everyone, I just want to bring to your attention to the first screen here that's showing up. We are in the thick of our App Forum, Elevating Enterprise Intelligence, series of events. We have three events remaining this year. We had our one in Europe, and it was incredibly successful and informative, and we encourage everybody to evaluate a potential attendance at one or more of these events. And we're going to kick off our Sydney event on August 13th, following with Beijing, and then we're going to be in Americas in Las Vegas, October 1st and 2nd. And you can register and pre-register for all the events at zebra.com/appform.com. So you can go ahead and join us, and we'd love to see you there. And the other thing is, for today's webinar, a few housekeeping rules. So we'll let Mukesh Prahapa go through his presentation today, and we will hold questions until the end. At such time, you can go ahead and type in your questions in that chat room, and we can address them. And any one of our team members noted here under this particular entrance slide here will be available to address any of your specific questions. So with that, I am going to turn over to Mukesh, and thank you very much.
Thanks. I'm going to start on what is Enterprise Keyboard. Enterprise Keyboard is a soft input keyboard that is built on top of stock Android keyboard. It's basically meant for fast and accurate in typing for customers in the enterprise domain. Enterprise keyboard can be configurable, and it the configuration files can be deployed by using EMM tool. It has a specific scan tab with the keyboard for scanning directly into the app. You can see here in the right hand side we have four tabs. One is numeric, alphanumeric, symbol, and scan tabs. So user can directly click on the navigation tab to switch to the specific tab layout. Enterprise keyboard also support custom keyboard layouts, which I am going to discuss detail about this in upcoming slides. The enterprise keyboard also support personal dictionaries using MX. Scan tab. User can switch to by clicking on the tab navigation, user can switch to a scan tab, and on click of the tab, they can scan a barcode and collect the data whenever it needed. And that admin and the user can also configure the EKV tab layouts. We can also enable, and suppose we don't want numeric layouts, then we can disable it, and we can only get alphanumeric, symbol, and scan layouts. So these things can be is configurable, and it can be pushed via MDM tool. Navigation. We can navigate to one layout to other layout via two ways. One is by swapping the tabs, and another is by using the key. Key mode is also we can set it via EKV settings, and or we can also use EMM tool to configure that. EKV also has a voice input key which appears on the right top corner in the suggestion bar. So by clicking on the this icon, we can give voice input, and it is based on Google Voice IME. For the long press key, user can type it by using click option. So they don't have to do the long press, so they can increase productivity. Now we are also supporting numeric mode in the calculator mode. So in the numeric mode, basically the numeric tabs appear in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9 mode. So we can configure it to calculator mode, then it will appear in 7, 8, 9, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3 mode. Enterprise keyword can also be remapped, and currently we are supporting 6 remappable key. Basically, the first column of our numeric layout is remappable, and the tab is the tab keys in our alphanumeric layout, and the emoji key of our symbol layouts. So all the 6 keys remappable, and the user can set a specific action for that. We also support personal dictionary, so user can give via MX.
So I would like to add a few. I would like to bring the additional requirements that we've been getting from customer, as Mukesh mentioned here. With all the fixed layout capabilities we have in enterprise keyboard, it was not enough for our enterprise customers to meet their certain capabilities. So as you could see in this slide, there were quite a few requirements from enterprise customers where they wanted to have certain selected keys only available in the key layout. And Mukesh will go through these requirements here. Mm-hmm. And these are an extension to the existing enterprise keyboard, and the upcoming custom key layout capability Mukesh is going to go through. It's basically an extension to the existing enterprise keyboard solution.
We got an requirement from customers for the small screen device like WT6000, that where customer is not able to see the background content, so customer want to transparent the key layouts. For the other side pages application and landscape pages, you can see the extra room is available for keyboard. So we are placing vertical key for that. So we got several requirements from different customers, and we have where we are created custom layouts, which is this type of layouts are not possible in with the fixed layouts. So we have proposed a custom layout for the customer. So and we are providing a tool where customer can create layouts for their requirement, and it is consumed in the EKV. Enterprise keyword creator tool has these properties which I am going to show in the live demo, and now I am going to launch our keyword creator tool. This is the home page of enterprise keyword designer tool. So here we have two options. One, we can create a new layout, and another one is to import the existing layout. To create a new layout project, we have to click on that. We have to type the layout project name. The layout project contains multiple layouts, and it is saved in a single package which is .encrypted file. And the project name is whatever project name we are giving, that will be our file name, and the .encrypted file we will receive. So here we have to type our file name and click on submit button. So I am not creating new layout. If user has an existing layout, they can directly import that layout and customize it as per the requirement. So I am going to click on import key project. So now we have an option to choose the device. You can see in the dropdown, these devices are supported in the keyword designer utility tool. So if we select any device, the device will appear in the screen. So it means the device is selected. So now we can confirm to go to the next option. Currently, I'm going to use only TC51, the default one. So now I have a device orientation option. Here we can choose either portrait mode or landscape mode. User can basically choose as per the requirement. So now I am going with the landscape mode. So now my keyword designer tool is ready for the layout creation. So now you can see here I have already created layouts. These are showing here. So all these layouts are saved in a single file, and it is, when we download, when we save the project, so it will we will get the encrypted file. Now I'm going to create a new layout, and so basically we have also an option to change the device settings at the layout level. If you want to create a layout for the landscape device or portrait device, we can also select from here. Now there are two ways to create layouts. One is via mouse drag and drop option, and another one is via grid layout. So first I am going with mouse drag and drop option. So using freehand mouse drag and drop, we can drag the layouts and create the background button. This background button is a key panel where we can drop the specific key. As per our requirement, we can drop the key. I am picking random keys and dropping in the key background key. After dropping the key, you can see we are getting these properties, button properties are getting enabled. So we can change the text of the button. So it is reflecting here, you can see. So we can also change the font size. We can change the text color if we want. Text styles also can be configured. We can also add secondary text for a specific key. Key action, long press action, action up and action down. These actions are also configured for a particular key. If you want to change to key in caps, we have to type the key in caps value, and then our key is ready. We can also configure background color for the specific button via button color and color paste. Instead of giving us background color, we can also select image for a particular key. The image and image paste option are for selecting an image for a particular key. We can also choose haptic feedback option to on and off if user as per their requirement. So now I am moving to the second option. We have three buttons. Before going to the grid layout, I want to explain these three buttons. We have if user want to clear the layout and they want to start with the beginning, so they can use the clear layout option to clear the layout. We can also save the layout before moving to the next project. We have to save the layout, so we can click on the save layout option. Then we can move to the next layout option. We have a save project option. By clicking on the save project, my layout will be all the layouts will be saved and we will get the encrypted file. I will show that at the end. And now I am moving to the grid layout option. So by clicking on the create grid layout option, we will get the grid option. Before going to that, I am going to clear the layout so that we can start with the beginning. So now I am clicking on the create grid layout option. So you can see here we are getting the group of buttons. So these are the grid properties. This is configurable and we can set as per the requirement. We can change the left. We can set the left top value. Height width value is also configurable. We can change the row value, row and column. I'm going to change row value to 2 and column value to 8. You can see it is reflecting in the emulated device screen. So now I am clicking on the save grid option. So you can see the grid layout is saved. The background button color can also be configured by using this background color key panel. If user want to create a transparent keyboard, then we have to set the transparency to 80-90, whatever they have the requirement, we can set the transparency. This is for the background color transparency, and for the specific key transparency, we have to select the specific key and apply the transparency level. The key properties are also enabled for the grid option, so we can select the individual key and apply the keyboard button properties for them. So we can also set the transparency for the specific key. You can see now it is a transparent key. So after finishing the project, we have to click on the save project option. By click on the save project, my keyboard project will be saved and it will be downloaded in the download option. You can get the respective folder in the pop-up window. So I already have created some layouts which I am going to show in the device. I have pushed the same file in the device. This is our SAP page where a user want to log in, and in this page, see, I have launched the QWERTY queue layout. So here user can type. Now you can see in the second page, in the second same page, we have an extra room for the available here. So in this place, I want to place my vertical keyboard. So we can do that. See, I have created one vertical layout, which I am going to show in the tool as well as in device. Now you can see the in the device skin and my shared in my the emulated device skin and the live device skin both has the vertical keyboard. And here, as per our requirement for function keys F2, F3, F4, and F8, I have created this layout. And we only need the 6 keys, so I have given the 6 key and the enter button. So it is based on the user requirement. They can create custom layouts as per their requirement and create the encrypted file and push in the device. Now I am moving to our presentation. After creating our encrypted file, we can push it via EMM tool. So for the mass deployment, we can push it via EMM tool. So the key layouts can be set to the based on the activity level, or we can set it via intent APIs. Intent APIs is available for enterprise keyboards, so we can programmatically call the intent and set the specific custom layout for the for it. And if user don't want to change their code, they can use they can go via database option. So we can associate particular key to the particular activity. Now I'm done with the presentation. We can take a query here.
Wow, great. Thanks. Yeah, thanks so much for everything, guys. It was an excellent presentation. I just wanted to open up the floor to questions. At the present moment, it doesn't appear we have any. So if anybody has any, please place those in the chat room and we'll go ahead and announce those and get your questions answered. As a reminder, we encourage you to visit our Zebra developer portal at developer.zebra.com. You can sign up for any news and events such as our Dev Talks here, App Forum, podcasts, and other events and pieces of information. Joining our ISV program is encouraged as well, but we would encourage you to participate and find other information such as this presentation and other pieces on Enterprise Browser on that developer portal. So with that, I'm just going to give it a few moments here to see if there's any other questions. Okay, so we have a few that are coming up now. So let's see what I can do to help out. Why must I choose my device? Must I define the keyboard again if I use another device? Guys, if you could take that question.
Yeah, basically the question, Mukesh, here regarding the device skin selection. So if you have chosen once and defined the layout, why do we have to select again? That's, I believe, if you are dealing with another layout, then you need to choose for every layout a device skin.
For every layout, we have to choose the device orientation, not the device screen. Device skin is selected only once, but the device orientation can be specific to the layout.
Okay, that's one of a few questions here. I have another one. When can we start playing with Enterprise Keyboard Designer? When will it be released?
There'll be a formal announcement on the date soon. So please look forward to it.
Okay, and that's something that we can announce on our developer portal. So we would encourage you to visit there for any updates. Okay. Yes, go ahead.
So we'll take it up, announcing it on a portal. But there is a formal announcement pending on the date, release
right.
date. Once that is done, yeah, we could definitely use that information on our sources we have, communication channels we have.
Right, and if you have any more questions, we can address it there as well for anybody. Okay, can you configure a button to send a specific hex code, or can you just select the action with the drop-down menu?
I believe you can define the action also for any particular key, and we are giving certain, the basic ones part of the drop-down list. And if you want to go beyond that, you could do that as well. You can define your own. And that feature, I believe, not part of the version we are showing at the moment. So it's a part of our backlog. At the moment, you are restricted to the list, whatever we are providing. I mean, as is the tool version stands.
Okay, great. Here's a good question. Where can we download the designer tool?
Sorry, can you come on it?
Stacey, was there another question?
The question was, where can we download the designer tool?
Oh, it will be made available part of our developer tools. So when we will be releasing this, it will be made available part of our developer tools section.
Okay, we had a couple of questions in that area, so that's good. The next question, is it possible to only change the colors of the default keyboard? So are we able to edit the default layouts, or do we always have to create layouts from scratch?
I take this as a question related to the existing fixed layout. So the question maybe is on a fixed layout, whether they can do some customization to the existing fixed layout. If that is the case, currently it is not visible. You'll have to start with a new layout for any of your customization. And that this requirement particularly is in our backlog at the moment.
Righty. Let me get to the next question here. Kathy asks, can a keyboard layout be created to support both portrait and landscape modes?
Okay. Could you repeat the question?
Of course. Can a keyboard layout be created to support both portrait and landscape modes?
Yes, it is supported. But we are recommending to create a layout for the specific